church did not grow because of any human plan. Church grew first and foremost because of persecution, because of pain, because of difficulty. So one of the short principles of growth is difficulty, is pain. We must pass through the crucible of suffering before we can truly grow. The plane does not just fly into the air, it has to struggle first and foremost before it can fly. And so it was the same for the church. If not for persecution, the early Christians would have just been content with staying in Jerusalem, where Jesus led them. They would have just sat in their comfort zones. They would have been there waiting for the second coming of Christ, doing nothing to spread the gospel. But because of persecution, we are told of the places where they traveled to. They traveled to Phoenicia, to Syria, to Antioch, and from there to the rest of the world. So persecution, that pain, that difficulty, is one important principle of growth that we can never, ever push to the background. So what that means is that if you express pain, whether in your spiritual life, whether in your secular life, you must learn to use it well. Pain is not meant to ground you forever. It is meant to help you to grow from one level to another, as it did for the apostles. Also, you find that another principle that helped them to grow was that as they were scattered to all of these places, they ministered the gospel to the people. So what that means is that every single one of them was a minister. How did it ever happen that priests and lay people, there is that dichotomy to the extent that a lay person does not see himself anymore as a minister? It is a very wrong idea of church. Everyone is a minister, so that wherever you find yourself, you will have the capacity to sow the seed of Christ. That's exactly what happened. They knew the word of God, whether priests, whether the apostles, or whether the people. They knew the word of God, each and every man and woman. And so, know your stuff if you want to grow. You must know your audience if you want to grow. As many as were scattered, they each knew the word of God, they each knew about the resurrection, they believed it, that's why they could spread it. That's the second reason. Every man was a minister. And lastly, we are told that the hand of the Lord was with them. So, after all of this, perhaps the most important key element to growth Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Thank you. act of spiritual communion. Oh my God, I firmly believe that you are truly present in the Blessed Sacrament of the altar. I adore you. I love you above all things, and desire with all my heart to receive you into my soul. But since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my soul and dwell and remain there forever. I embrace you as though you have already come, and unite myself entirely with you. Do not permit me to be ever separated from you again. Jesus, in the Blessed Sacrament of the altar, have mercy on the dying. Jesus, in the Blessed Sacrament of the altar, have mercy on the dead. Jesus, in the Blessed Sacrament of the altar, grant us a holy and happy death. Amen. O Sacrament most holy, O Sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be in every moment thine. O Sacrament most holy, O Sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be in every moment thine. O Sacrament most holy, O Sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine.
103, hymn number 103.
Tonight.